as you've seen there, today's walk's Meall Nan Tarmachan, and, as well, if the weather keeps up, the Tarmachan Ridge. Meall Nan Tarmachan is 1,043 metres and is located in the Perth and Kinross area. Now, from the walk description you get on Walkhighlands website, it actually says to start the walk from the Benlaws car park. Now, this is actually quite a high car park and starts 420 odd metres high. Once you've left the car park, you'll come across an old disused quarry road. As you can see here, just walk straight across it to start the slog up Meall Nan Tarmachan. Now, I've done this walk twice, and the twice I've done it, I've known it to be a slog. It's always been either really windy or really rainy. And in today's case, it was a bit of both, with, of course, the cloud hiding everything in sight. But it's one of those things though, nature of the beast, I suppose. Gotta get yourself out there, gotta see the non-existent views even at the worst of times, and then get out and see the views at the best of times. And much like anything else, it can all be due to the company you actually keep as well. That can make or break a good walk, I think. And walking with my sister-in-law and my wife, you couldn't have really picked a better dynamic duo to really keep the moods going, even though the weather was like this. Now, we're actually coming up to one of the points where you should be looking out for on the path. It's a cairn, it's actually at the top. At the top of a never-ending, zigzagging, relentless, winding path up this mountain. 923 metres is where you'll be at there. Once you've reached the cairn, just follow the path down, which your next point should actually be a turnstile, which you can see here. Now, once you've gone over the turnstile, you should come to a big boulder that I've actually started to call Sweat Slap Stone. Now, the reason it's called Sweat Slap Stone is because the very first time I've ever done this Munro, I was walking with Shannon and her dad Ian. Now, Ian was a bit sweaty to say the least, and what he's decided to do is swap his t-shirt over to a more fresher one. That's what I'd done with the old one. It was brought against the rock and made such a slap it sounded like thunder, and I actually thought there was thunder incoming. And that's the story of Sweat Slap Stone. Once you do reach Sweat Slap Stone, this is actually quite a good time to get some lunch in you, because just ahead is actually the last climb up to Meall Nan Tarmachan. For us, this is more of an opportunity to try and see if the weather's going to clear, and we were getting glimpses of good weather, so we decided to possibly do the ridge this day, and we'll see what it's like actually at the top. However, we still had the climb to go before we actually got to that point yet. So, let's go on. Now, as you can see here, it's not exactly flat here, it is quite a steep climb up. You do have the aid of some steps, however, in wet conditions these can be quite slippy, so yeah, just best taking your time and being careful on the... Oh, yep, there you go, that just shows you how steep it is. So this is us just heading up to the summit of Meall Nan Tarmachan. So from here, obviously, you take the left. Sometimes some people can take the right and obviously get a bit confused with that. But yeah, so take the left, keep going along here, and you'll see the summit here in just a wee second. And there you go. There's the cairn at Meall Nan Tarmachan. So we'll just wait here for a wee second, taking the views, if there is any, whilst we're waiting for these two just to come up and give the cairn a wee touch, leave their wee stones on. And there you have it, that's almost at the top, but you've not reached the top unless you've touched it. So just give them a wee second to get their stones out, get themselves ready. Kind of chucked over, but there we go, yep, you're at the top, way. So we'd all made it safely to the top, of course, and at this point we just kind of needed to see how the weather was going to go, and as you can see there with the big drip right across the camel lanes, yeah, the weather wasn't getting much better. It was getting a little bit more clearer, because as I mentioned before earlier, we were going to try and do the Tarmachan Ridge, So we did decide to walk on a little bit further just to see how we're going to get on with the weather, because as you can see here, we're getting little parts here of visibility here and there. It's getting more and more so as we keep walking. But yeah, like I say, we're just constantly reevaluating everything and making sure that everything's going to be safe for us whilst we're on that ridge. So the further along we walked, the more visibility we actually gained, and you can actually see here more of the actual ridge itself, or starting to come the ridge itself. This here is actually Meall Nan. Walk along it and this actually becomes, like I say, part of the ridge. So for point of reference, on my right hand side here in just a few seconds you'll see two lochans. There's a big one just immediately in front of us, and more further down the back there's a little one. These actually have got little posts, they're more for guiding and stuff like that. But yeah, the path's quite clear all the way up and round. So as you can see here, the visibility at different points is actually very good, and other points, as you can see here, it's not so good. This was a consistent thing for most of the rest of the walk, so we just decided, you know what, we'll just go along with the ridge, and it should be fine. And this is us actually just getting to the first part of the ridge itself. So you've got a good head for heights, that's great, but if you don't, then obviously don't look down, of course, but I will do in a wee second. I'll just show you how exposed this actually is. There you go. Yeah, you'll be definitely rolling right down that one anyway. And this is the first look you get of the ridge right here. Now, in all seriousness, I did actually put the camera away and I stopped filming, because there was a lot of down climbing and a lot of stuff that you kind of had to concentrate on, and I had to make sure that everyone was okay. And I mean, don't get me wrong, everyone's more than capable to do this, but there is points when it's very exposed and you do have to climb over. So yeah, your best working as a team, make sure it's all safe. Now, of course, you can tell this part is very exposed. The only thing is that I don't know if it's actually in our favour that we can't actually see anything and actually see the hundreds of metre drop below us, but you know what, it was, you still felt that you were still on a knife edge, possibly. So yeah, it was one of those ones, you still need to be careful. So after a few more exposed parts, climb downs and climb ups, we eventually came to this. The skies opened up and actually showed us what we were actually missing, which was glorious. It's just a shame in a way that we couldn't actually got to see it on the ridge itself, but you know what, like I said just a wee second ago, I don't know if that would actually put the fear in us, but yeah, it was actually nice to see this though, really nice. So where are we right now? Well, we're coming off Ben and Nikin, and we're actually just about to come up to Creagna Calic. So what we're looking for here is a small cairn, which you can see to your left hand side, and that's the way up to Creagna Calic. So take this wee faint path down, and then that'll be you starting to head all the way down. Now this part here is very boggy. The path, as you can see here, is faint. It doesn't get much better than this, as you can see right now. But yeah, it does need a little bit of care, because there is some pretty bad peat bogs down at this part. So yeah, like I say, just take your time and make sure you're not stepping into a big massive bog. So from here you're looking for a disused quarry on your left hand side. Once you've found that, just stay on this road and that's you. Just follow this all the way back till you see the road to the car park. Now this walk, I actually fairly enjoyed it, and I know the other two, they fairly enjoyed it as well. Took us 6 hours and 45 minutes. So yeah, it was a long day, don't get me wrong, but it was a very, very good day. Very enjoyable. Now before we go, I'm just going to leave you with Jungle Jane attempting the long jump. go. She's preparing for her dismount. Perfect execution. And graceful like a gazelle. Look at that. Lovely. Smiles all round.